Nothing to worry about. Those are just the regular run-of-the-mill Hollywood zombies. They've been around in countless TV shows and movies since the late 1960s in Hollywood. They are kind of based in some historical characters. We can go all the way back to 2500 BCE in probably what's known as the oldest written story. It was written on clay tablets, the Epic of Gilgamesh, where King of Uruk mentions that the dead will come up and outnumber the living, and they will devour the living, right? So these are ancient creatures. But zombie itself actually comes from a whole different culture, right? That wasn't born in Hollywood. We can go back to the mid-1700s, where slaves from Central Africa, particularly the Congo region, were transported to Haiti to work on the plantations. And with them came their cultures and their religion. And then the slave owners played upon that, right? They used their religion against them. So the word zombie in the Congo language is actually the word for soul. The plantation owners, fearing that the slaves would commit suicide as a way to escape, warned them, said, if you commit suicide, you will offend the Baron, the Lord of the Cemetery, who is to transport you back to heaven. You will offend him and you'll become a zombie and then be an eternal slave working on your plantation forever, right? So they actually utilized their own religion against them. So those zombies out in the hallway, right? Those are kind of the Hollywood, like I said, flesh-eating zombies, really not too much to worry about. And they came, they originated out of George Romero's 1969 film, Night of the Living Dead. He didn't even call them zombies in the original movie, in the original script. Rather, they were flesh eaters, and eventually became what we now know as the zombie. But for Romero, these were more than just mere cannibals or mere zombies of flesh eating, right? They were the actual metaphors for societal ills. Whether it was multiculturalism or class differences, right? They could be an avalanche or a flood or a hurricane, right? This was the idea that we make poor decisions from time to time in the face of that. Gotta go. As we've said before, there are lots of different zombies in the world, and the Hollywood zombie is not the only one, certainly not the first. Most of these zombies in different cultures and different parts of the world are ancient creatures. They've been around for as long as humanity's been around. And we needed them to do a couple things for us. One, they help us explain infectious disease, right? When we didn't have the idea of germ theory and microscopes and biology and chemistry, zombies were an easy way to explain the infectious disease process. And every culture, as I said, has some sort of creature. Many of them have similarities and have similar ways of dying and becoming a zombie. So we know that there's some oral tradition that moved about the globe. For example, there's the Chinese hopping zombie, right? This idea that the zombie themselves, if you died in an unnatural way, they come back to life and will haunt you or come after you until they receive a proper burial. We needed zombies to kind of explain the history of disease and disease occurrence, right? But as we move into the 20th century and the development and advancements of the microscope and the eventual germ theory idea, we've kind of gotten away from the need for zombies. Now they're more of this entertainment. But germ theory really advanced science for us. This idea that we have these little microscopic creatures that can infect and cause disease, okay? And we have ways to prevent them. The funny thing, though, about disease is they evolve like everything else, like we evolved. Diseases evolve as well. We even see new diseases starting to emerge, right? More than 30 new diseases have emerged since the 70s, things that we had never seen before. Some have burned through the population and are now gone. Others are still with us, like HIV, Ebola, right? And now, even today, we hear about coronavirus, right? This is a new disease that emerged. Nobody has any immunity, and we're going to see it move through the population. Zombies are necessary. We see them in every culture around the world. They're not what they were, say, hundreds of years ago. Today, they're more for entertainment and fun and excitement, but it's also a way for us to explore what the end of the world might be like without it being too scary.